Hello everyone, I'm Martina, aka Mortinfamia. Today, I'm here to introduce you to a series of tutorials on how to create your very own webcomic from scratch. We're gonna be using Clip Studio Paint, because it offers a lot of handy and intuitive tools to illustrate our story in the format we want. I'll show you every step from the character design to the page layout and how to arrange your work to make it ready for publication. But I won't be talking about genre, settings, or plots, since those three points all depend on you and your imagination. In this first video, we'll get to know the basics of Clip Studio's workspace and get ready to sketch our character. Before we get into the character design, I'll show you how you can organize the windows of your workspace. This is how I set up my personal Clip Studio. As you can see, these are the windows I always have open. Navigator to keep an eye on my work as a whole. Layers, essential for any digital work, which I'll talk about in detail in the next videos. Tool column, where I pick the pen, brush or pencil I need and adjust its properties. Color column, where we have the color wheel and my own personal color palette, which I'll show you how to create in the next videos. Of course, this is the workspace I feel comfortable with, but you can organize your workspace in any way you like. Now that our workspace is ready, let's create a new project and get to our protagonist's character sheet. To customize our canvas, let's click on the second icon on the horizontal toolbar, the one with the small plus. A square project is fine for a character sheet. I personally use at least a 3000 by 3000 pixel canvas. In the next videos, I'll show you how to create a project better fitting the webcomic page format. Now, which is the best brush to sketch with? I've always found the pencil tool great for the job. As you can see here, Clip Studio offers many pencils to choose from, and each one has properties you can adjust to your liking and need. We can modify the tool we are using in the Tool Property window to decrease or increase its grain, the stabilization, etc. I warmly welcome you all to take some time to experiment with the many types of pencils, since each of them will make your sketch look different. Feel free to pick the one you like best. One of the best things of Clip Studio is the possibility to look for tools through the asset page. You can find this page either by clicking on the first icon of the horizontal toolbar and then scrolling down to the Clip Studio Assets section, or by typing it on any search engine and using your account on Clip Studio's website. There is a huge load of stuff in Assets. Hundreds of brushes, textures, useful resources for mangas and illustrations, and even 3D material. But the best thing has yet to come. Once you download what you want, it will be automatically loaded in your program. You will find it in the Materials drop-down menu, which you can go to on the horizontal toolbar, then click Window and Material. Or click the button with the angle brackets nearby the top left corner of the navigator. Now that we chose the tool for our sketch, let's get down to business. Surely you already have a rough idea of your character in mind, but the best way to improve and polish it is to make or look for references. Clothes are a good example. If you have a setting in mind, you can look up pics or images that portray people or things in that specific setting, so you can make outfits that fit your story well. To avoid jumping from your browser or pic viewer to your Clip Studio window, I'm gonna show you two different working methods. The first one is really basic. You can load your references in another canvas, then extract that tab and resize it along with the Clip Studio window, so that you can keep an eye on both at the same time. This way, you can also modify the references if you need, like rotating them or sampling a color. But you'll need to switch Canvas to modify every single file. The second one uses the SubView palette functions, which you can find under the Window button in the horizontal menu. This window allows you to load multiple images into it and transform them very easily. Thanks to its toolbar, you can zoom, rotate, and flip each pick while never leaving your main canvas. You can also color pick from any of them with the eyedropper and use it right away on your canvas. So, once you've found everything you think can be used as a visual reference for your character, you are ready to start drawing your character. Ready to bring your protagonist to life? We'll get to drawing the character in the next video. See you next time!